Hello students, in this lesson let us study about the harbors and its classification. So we'll see what exactly is the definition of the harbor and we'll see the classification. Normally the classification is based on the protection needed, utility and location. So that we will see in detail. So as navigation developed, ships felt the necessity to find shelter during their course, and hence across the creation of haves where ships could take in and discharge passengers and cargo under the protected conditions. So harbors basically are what? They can be also defined or called as basins, haves, or roadsheds of navigable water well under the protected condition. Okay, they should be under protected condition. That is very important. So if you want to write the exact definition of a harbor, it is a basin or haven or roadshed of navigable water well protected. Now this protection can be either given naturally or artificially. Artificially like man-made given, okay? And this protection should be given against what? This protection should be normally given against your action of wind and waves. And this harbor is situated along the seashore or coastline or river or lake or canal connected to the sea. So basically where exactly we need it, we need to provide the harbor. So normally basin is a water reservoir of required area. It is said to be navigable when depth of water in basin is greater than the draft required for the largest slip likely to visit the harbor. Draft is nothing but what? The extra space which is required in the basin below the depth of the sea in which the water should be able to navigate. The boat should be able to navigate. Okay, so you should give certain allowance so that the bottom of the ship should not touch the bed of the sea. That is your navigable water. So draft is vertical linear immersion of ship below water surface for the ship to float in stable condition safely. Okay, safe floating requires a standard vertical clearance between your bottom part of the ship and the sea bed. By chance, if the ship of the basin goes out of trim or out of plumb, that means not vertical, some part of the ship goes lower than the usual level and the remaining part of the ship comes above your usual level. In such what condition, what will happen? The safety cover will take care of the ship and the ship bottom will not touch the sea bed. So we have to take care of this, and this is some of the information about your harbors. As the method of navigation improved, the ships gradually increased in size, numbers, and importance. So there arose a need of providing a stable and accommodation. So the harbors have been classified accordingly. So there are basically three divisions of classification. Let us see them one by one. This is the classification. The first classification is based on the protection that is needed. So classification depending upon the protection needed. The next one is depending upon the utility. Why exactly are you using that harbor based on that? As we discussed, is upon the protection needed. There are T types. Suppose you see this figure, there is a harbor. So along the sides, you can see this, there is protection, right? This protection is for the action of winds and water, right? Waves. So that the portion in the basin will be safe and the ships can properly be parked or stopped. Okay, these are of three categories: natural harbor, semi-harbor harbor, and artificial harbor. Harbors are also called as roadsteads. If you observe, this figure shows the natural harbor or natural roadshed. So these are the different types of natural harbors which you'll come across. The first one is what? You'll just have some landmass on both sides of the harborage area. Okay, so these are naturally formed. We don't have to construct anything here. The natural formations are offering safe discharge facilities for ships on the sea coast in the form of creeks and basins are called as your natural harbors. So in other words, what you can say is natural harbor is an inlet protection from storm and waves by natural configuration of land. Okay, that is nothing but your natural harbor. Normally protect the inside area from your storms and waves by natural configuration of the land. So this figure shows this is the landmass. From both sides, you can observe that there is a landmass. In between, you have the harborage area. So the shape is in such a way that the wind is resisted on both the sides, right? And there is entry provided for your ships only at the center here. This is nothing but your natural harbor. This is the second type wherein you have small shovels or creeps, and in between that you have the roadshed. Okay, so you see here there are small land masses everywhere, it is protected, and in between this is also one type. Naturally circumscribed roadshed. It is observed that in all the sides you have landmass, but there are some two entries and one exit as visible here, and in between you have the harborage area. In between the roadshed will be there. This is one of the type of your natural harbor. This is normally called as confined area, naturally enclosed by islands. The next one is the semi-natural harbor. Here what will happen is there will be land mass only on one side. But in order to make it as a harborage area, you should need protection both sides. Artificial construction, what we do is called as your breakwaters. And then finally, our harborage area will be done. It is called as semi-natural. Half of it is natural, half of it we are going to do it. Okay. These breakwaters are also called as dredging. In India, the Visakhapatnam port is nothing but your semi-natural harbor. Okay. And the natural harbor is your Bombay and Kandal natural harbor, if you just want the example. So Visakhapatnam port will come under the semi-natural harbor. The next one is your artificial harbor. There is no availability of any landmass or anything. We have to construct it and make shelter and use the engineering skills to make this harborage area. Such type of harbors are called as artificial harbors, or sometimes they are also called as man-made harbors. Okay, we will create what? Breakwaters, the area where you want the harborage area. These breakwaters are also called as dredging. Okay, dredging is nothing but removal of the extra content or below the seabed so that we can get navigable waters. So the Madras Harbor, Chennai Harbor is nothing but the best example for your artificial harbor. This is the typical layout of an artificial harbor. This is your approach channel or entrance. You'll have breakwaters on the either side. So from here is where your ship will inside. You'll have a turning basin for turning the direction of the ship. There will be a jetty. Piers will be there, breaths will be there, wherein you can park your ships, right? There will be a quay also available. So we can plan accordingly, however we want, based on the requirement. Okay. So normally naval vessels would contain shelter during bad weather within a tract of area of water close to the shore, providing a good hold for anchoring, protected by natural or artificial harbors, walls against the fury of storm. Such good breathing condition, such roadsheds could be naturally available or artificially created. So this artificial harbor can be of curvilinear type or artificially circumscribed roadshed, which is there only available on one side. Okay, so you'll have a solid wall on one side. Okay, which comes on the coastal line. Okay, this is normally curvilinear in shape. And the next one is a artificially subscribed right? So here you can see the solid wall on both the sides, and in between there will be a navigable water. These are also called as confined basins or areas. Solid walls are sometimes also called as jetties. There's one more type called as the confined basin type. Okay, here what we do is we try to give the inlet separately and the exit separately so that we can make narrow entrances and narrow exits, and we try to confine the action of water and waves and winds inside. So these type are normally given for shipping. So you see there are two solid walks. In between also there is one solid walk, and there is a shore. This is your basin. This you can call as inlet, and this you can call as outlet. This type of basins are also called as confined basins. We can give in small areas, especially for fishing, as I quoted the example. Okay, no much expenses, we can construct this type of road sheds. Okay, so these are the types of basins which are based on the protection needed. Moving on to the next one, it is the classification based on the utility. So where exactly we are using the harbor, for what purpose, based on that we have the classification. The first one is your harbourage refuge, commercial harbourage, fishery harbourage, military harbourage, marina harbourage. What is harbourage of refuge? It is whenever there is a breakdown or disable or damaged ships under stress of weather condition, so at that time we can go for harbourage of refuge. So all type of naval craft, small and big, will need refuge in an emergency, and hence such refuge harbor should provide accommodative accommodation. Modern big ships will require a lot of elbow rooms for the purpose of mooring or turning above. So we have to make sure of that. The next one is for commercial purpose. So it should be spacious enough. It should have facilities for loading, unloading, and transportation of cargo. It should have shelters for the cargoes. Then good and quick repair facilities should be there to not to allow any delay. And more sheltered conditions, as loading and unloading could be done with advantage in calmer waters. Okay, so they should be situated on coasts or big rivers. Okay. Next is your fishery harbors, basically used for fishery purpose. Military harbors, basically used for military purpose, navy purpose, right? And the last one is the marina harbor. This is an important one. It is an harbor which provides facility of fuel, food, showers, washing machines, telephones, etc. And for small boat owners having temporary or permanent berths wherein they can park their ships. Okay. So basically, for people who are traveling in ships, if they want to rest somewhere, take recreation somewhere, they can go for the marina harbors. Understood? Marina harbors are classified into large marina harbors and small marina harbors. So large marina harbors will have 200 or more berths and caters large boat. Time space available is limited, and hence creates a long waiting list to get berth. But in small marina harbors, less than 100 berths will be there, and they are located normally in the fresh water and the coastal waters. Normally we should give all resort facilities, yacht club facility, sports fish facilities, marina pubs, everything we should give in the marina harbors. Okay, marina harbors will be provided where big volume of population for recreation will come there. So we have to give this. They are of large and small sizes. So as mentioned, greater than 200 berths, then it is large. And if it is less than 200, it will come under the small marina harbors. So these are the classifications of harbors based on the utility. Next one is the last type of classification, or the third type of classification, is based on the location of the harbor. So where exactly is it located? Based on that, you have the classification of harbors. So let's see. So this one, you have core categories: canal harbor, lake harbor, river or estuary harbor, sea or ocean harbor. So beside which they have situated canal, beside the canal, artificially made river, right? Lake or river or sea, these are classified. Okay, so this is how your harbors have been classified. Okay, hope this lesson is clear to you now. Thank you.